Hello and welcome to this special episode of the Weekend Investing Daily Bites. We're shooting the performance report for Q4 and Financial 23. Also, I'm very sorry for the background construction noise that I have to deal with today. Let's dive into the financial year. It's been a tough year. Overall, if I look back the entire year, we've really not gone anywhere in terms of the Nifty. We have started the Nifty somewhere around 17,400, and we are still, at the end of March, somewhere near that is only. So roughly, a nothing sort of a gain year, although during the year we saw almost a 20% or at least a 15% drop from where we were at the start of the year, and then a huge gain from there of about 20%, and then again a fall. So basically three legs have happened during the year. So first quarter down, then two quarters up, and then one quarter down. So nullifying essentially all gains. But within the index, if we see, there have been, sectors that have really outperformed and sectors that have underperformed. So essentially, if we also compare Nifty with global index like SPX, S&P 500, we will find that while Nifty has not performed, S&P 500 is down almost 10% in the same period. So compared to the global peers, Nifty has still done reasonably all right. And from that perspective, we remain near the all-time highs, whereas other markets remain near 52-week lows. So that itself is telling us a picture about the future of the Indian market as we deal with the headwinds from global issues, from inflation, from rising interest rate cycle. But we are just simmering just below that all-time high. So that as and when these headwinds turn into tailwinds, we can be able to take off from here. So that is the sort of optimism that I hold for the market. Also, additionally, the hedge that we do in gold in some of our strategy has worked very well this year. You can see that for the financial year, while Nifty is flat, gold in INR terms is up more than 15%. And that has been a great hedge and a counterbalance to the equity portfolio. Besides these few strategies, Evergreen, NG50, etc., which have a component of gold, I always advise that you have asset allocation in gold, whether through sovereign gold bonds, physical ETFs, whichever way you like. But this is something that is very, very important in today's uncertain world. Yearly returns of Nifty, you can see here, we had about two or three down years in every decade. So this is the first decade from 2000 to 2009. We had three down years, one big one in 2008. Then in the next decade, we had 24% down in 2011. 2015, we were down marginally. And there were some, dot years where neither going up, neither going down kind of situation. And of course, this year, this decade so far, we had three green years, and now we have this flat year of 2023. So this is all again, I would say, part and parcel that every few years, we will find that, we get some lumpy gains, and then there is some sort of a correction. Some few years of good gains and then a correction, or flat years, then good gain, flat year. So this is all, sort of part and parcel of equity market, because the lumpy gains, in a way, jump forward and discount much more in a very short period, and then, allow the market to catch up. That is how the nature of the market is. If you see the last 30 years of data here, you'll find that, and these are yearly candles on the Nifty, you'll see that very few candles of down years are there, and big down years have only happened like twice or thrice. 2008 is here, 2011 is here, and then of course, if you see from a financial year perspective, or rather a calendar year perspective, even the COVID 2020 fall was fully made up within that year. That is also an amazing fact. And we had some red dots here in the 90s, which were marginal. So this drop that we are seeing in the current calendar is something that is, you know, even if we spend the entire year in this range, the probability that the next years will be good is very, very high, given the, you know, the history that every down year, every decent down year is followed by, you know, several up years. That has been the nature of the Indian market because of the growth runway that we have. So from that perspective, I would think that, you know, there's nothing really to worry about. As I was mentioning, in terms of sectors, PSU banks, FMCG, auto, public sector enterprise, these were some of the sectors that remained in the positive territory during the year. Whereas a lot of sectors, infrastructure, whether it was commodities, pharma, energy, metals, real estate, IT, media, they were all reeling badly in this financial year. And this is a sort of a monthly, 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, 12 months sort of momentum that we track. Although we don't use it in any of our strategies because those are, you know, sort of algorithmic based on price movements. But just to give you a sense of how things have moved, is that, you know, you can see here FMCG has, you know, remained in the top list, whether it was over 1 month, over 3 months, over 6 months. Public sector enterprises has remained largely in the top list. There are some sectors that are now coming back, you know, energy is coming back here. Financial services and infra is coming back. Gold as a sector is definitely top performing. Pharma is now coming back on a very short term basis. So these are some of the insights at the end of the financial year that you can, you know, take some cues from. The performance card is here. So Nifty 50, this is all the quarters of the year. So FY23, first quarter was down, second quarter was up by 8%, third quarter was slightly up, fourth quarter was down. Net result is virtually nothing. Nifty Next 50 was hit harder at -8%. CNX 200 was flat, mid and small cap index was flat, small cap index was down 7%, and CNX 500 was down 2.3%. So index, from an index perspective, no index was in the green really that we track. Within the weekend investing small cases also, we had some damages. NG 5050 and MI Evergreen did quite well, as I mentioned, due to exposure to gold. They were up at +8% and +7% for the year. India top 10 lost a significant amount at -8%. NNF 10 lost at -14.9%, largely in this last quarter when Adani stocks fell. You can see that, you know, it was really performing well in the Q2 as well as Q3, but Q4 was a damaging quarter for this. MI Evergreen, I've already mentioned. MI 20 and MI 50. MI 20 is mid and small cap. MI 50 is also mid and small cap, both flat. MI 25 has underperformed this year at -12.8% versus 7 on the small cap. MI 35 on the small cap is in line. MI 30 on CNX 500 is also pretty much in line. MI MT all cap has performed and underperformed quite significantly this year. I'm assuming that because of, you know, overperformance in previous years, this underperformance is also par for the course, in the sense that MI MT all cap is a very slow moving, you know, high volume oriented strategy. So it takes time to enter into stocks after going into cash, and it takes time to come out. So in that sense, sometimes, you know, this can be a drag for some time, but once it picks up momentum, it really goes fast. MI ATH has done -7.6%. So again, a drag on the strategy. And MI ATH 2 has done marginally at 1.3%. Slightly better than what its CNX 500 has done. So mixed bag here, a couple of big losses, big underperformances, couple of outperformances. So I think we are pretty much okay with what has happened in the year. A year like this does not come every now and then. So if you pass this year with minimal damage, I think this is a significant turn of events. So if I'll just quickly go through some of these charts since 2016, you can see here in India top 10 versus Nifty, So right now, India top 10 this year has underperformed, but over a longer period of time, it is likely to outperform the Nifty as it has done in this past historical data that we have. In terms of 3-year absolute rolling returns, 3-year absolute rolling returns on India top 10 is now very much in line with Nifty, but in the past it has outperformed. This year, because of the underperformance, the outperformance is minimal over a 3-year period, but over the past 5-6 years, if you see from 2019 onwards, 3 years, 16 to 19, you would find that almost on a yearly basis it does outperform. NNF10 is the strategy which tracks Nifty Next 50 index. That also, over since 2016, has been outperforming. This year has been a drag, but overall it has still outperformed the index over a period of time. In terms of the 3-year absolute rolling returns, it is pretty much in line with Nifty Nifty Next 50, primarily due to the current year. But you can see in the past it has rallied very, very hard versus the index on this. And MI Evergreen, you can see that overall the performance has, you know, extended, in the sense the lead is going up, and that is because of the design of the strategy with the hedge of gold. Since 16 till 20, it was pretty much tracking the CNX 200, but the major lead has come after post-COVID, and I think this will remain to be the case for many years to come, since gold is now entering into a new bull territory. So I'm very positive about this strategy going forward. On a 3-year absolute return basis also, you can see, you know, the current 3-year absolute rolling return is 151% versus 103 on the CNX 200. So really doing well on this strategy. NGV 50-50 is our free Nifty and gold strategy. You can use it freely. And this is something that you need to see, is that over the last 7 odd years, this has performed slightly better than the Nifty. So despite the hedge with gold, from where it was underperforming for the first 3 years, now it is pretty much in line with Nifty, and with a much, much more smoother curve than the Nifty, which is the dotted line. So this is something that you must look at in terms of, you know, keeping your idle capital. And of course, on a 3-year absolute rolling return, it trails Nifty, but in terms of average rolling returns, it is very much in line with Nifty here. MI20 is our mid and small cap strategy. Again, you can see it is doing quite well. It has maintained its pace versus the underlying index of mid and small cap index. And it has done well over the last 6-7 years. In terms of the last 3-year absolute rolling returns, it is doing quite well at 249% now versus 158%. So average in the last many years also, the average absolute rolling returns has been much, much higher than the index. So this is another favorite strategy, MI20, that I have. MI50 is a very, very well diversified 50 stock, up to 50 stock small and mid cap strategy, one of my favorites. This is the first strategy I started with. It has been running live since 2016. You can go back and check the blogs or Twitter accounts. This is the primary sort of first strategy that got all the attention to Weekend Investing, and that has really done well. I mean, of course, last few years have been a stagnation along with the market, but it has really, really done well. And despite such fantastic diversification, it has not let me down in terms of the return. So this is something that I really like, and you could look at. The MI50 on a 3-year absolute rolling return basis has done equally well as the mid and small cap index, and there is a likelihood that as index takes off, the overall lead will again get generated on this. MI25 is a purely small cap strategy. The chart says it all, how it has performed over the years. The small cap index has gone from 100 to 219. This strategy has gone from 100 to 572, and this has been running live since 2016 also. So many users have already experienced 6 or 7 years of this strategy, and they know how this performs once the momentum starts to go up. In terms of 3-year absolute rolling return, again, the absolute rolling return on a 3-year basis has been fantastic and pretty much in line with the small cap index for now, for the last 3 years. But prior to that, it was leading in a big way. MI35 is a purely small cap strategy on a rotational basis. So this is up to 35 stocks on and again, I mean, a fantastic performer. It does not go to cash and really allocates well. Again, on a long-term basis, fantastic outcome. And on a 3-year absolute rolling return, also a fantastic outcome at, you know, 246% versus 174 right now. MI30 is a long-term strategy of CNX 500 stocks, so it allocates to long, to large, mid, and small caps all together. Very, very stable long-term performance. This also has been running live since 2016, and this is a sort of a slower strategy, but you know it kind of keeps chugging along. And has performed decently well. So MI30 also, you can see how it has performed. Of course, the last year and a half has been sideways or slightly down for many strategies, but the momentum, once it comes, these strategies will go on fire. So again, a good outbeat on the base index, and on a 3-year absolute rolling return, also a great outcome over the last 3 years. MIMT All Cap is a bellwether strategy, again investing in large and mid caps largely. Small caps, if they are very, very liquid, also come to this strategy. It really did well in this period of 2020 to 22, but of late has been giving up some ground. The way it went off in the previous years, this comeback has been marginal in that context. But yes, if you have entered in the last year, year and a half, it has been a bit of a dampener for that period. Over a 3-year absolute rolling return period, it has still been rocking, clocking 213% versus 108 in the previous 3 years and any 3-year period before that. ATH is another rockstar strategy, which is a very niche strategy that you know, tracks all-time high stocks and chases them. Again, mostly large and mid caps, but if some small caps with very large volumes are available, it will pick those as well. And it also did very, very well in the high momentum period, but of late has been cooling off. But overall, a very, very good performance for those who have stuck with the strategy for long. And you can see the 3-year absolute rolling return also is very, very rocking on this strategy. So I'm very hopeful that these returns will come back. ATH2 was launched in 2021. It also has a historical data for very, very strong moves, but we have launched it somewhere in August 21 here. So it is yet to perform for people who have come in here, but I am very hopeful that once momentum comes back, this too will perform extremely well and create an absolute rolling return good for the users. So this is all I had for all the strategies. I would like to have a view that India is a very strong market. We have a very strong growth runway. It is mostly an international headwind that is causing us to pause. We are also sort of doing a time-based correction, in the sense that if we had run up a lot in the 18 months from March 2020 to October 21, we are kind of digesting those gains. And since the market will also always give you lumpy returns, I mean, you go back and look at history for the last 30 years, you will have in every 5 to 7 year period, you will have one or two lumpy return periods, one or two, you know, flat years, one or two down years, and that is what constitutes the market. So there is no need to get frustrated. There is no need to get disappointed or despondent about the markets. This is the nature of the markets. As long as you stick with a strategy that has a proven algorithm, you will do well. And with that, I'll come to an end to this presentation. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in another one. Bye.